were mentioning your 200% guarantee, which I think is a stroke of genius in a way, because I've gone through the experience of applying for visas, and of course it's not a very big expense, but it's very stressful for the family and for everyone involved. You don't know when you'll be approved, you don't know for how long you will be approved, and to have your own service provider essentially invest in you, because that's what you do, you're investing in your client, and so if you choose the wrong client, you have to pay him double. So I think that's a very honest way of doing service business, in the sense that every service business, in a way, whether they know it or not, they're essentially investing in their clients.
Yeah.
But most of them don't think about it that way. And I think it's, I was certainly, you know, when I had the experience of going through a website and choosing a service provider, I was quite impressed.
But it's all about risk, right? I mean, I can assess the risk. The customer can't assess the risk. The customer hasn't got a clue. They're relying on me to tell them. So if I say to them, yes, I can get you approved, well, that delivers confidence. But if I put my money where my mouth is, it delivers super confidence. But more importantly, it's about credibility. You know, if I'm positioning myself as the expert in this niche, then as far as I'm able to deliver, I should be able to deliver. And if I can't deliver, then what am I supposed to do? At the very least, I can, you know, provide some measure of, you know, monetary compensation and apologize for not having delivered. But that's, you know, something that's not that risky for me, actually, all things considered, because very rarely do we have to deliver on the guarantee. But when we have delivered on the guarantee in the past, just a few times, on two or three occasions, those customers who didn't get the visas have recommended this to other people. So, you know, they've completely flipped what should be a negative scenario into a positive scenario.
Right.
And you know, given that we publish in the way that we do and we don't have to spend money with any other people to address our audience, you might want to conclude that perhaps when we do have to give money back, it's just the cost of marketing.